So as these videos shows clear usage of Smith chart, we are going to show them in today's session. That will give you understanding of how to solve the numerical for a transmission line where we are asked to find various quantities like input impedance, reflection coefficient, then SWR, that is your standing wave ratio, or voltage standing wave ratio. Okay, sometimes it is asked in numerical like input impedance at certain length. Okay, in this we do have two different types of statements: input impedance at certain length from the load going towards the generator. This is first statement. I repeat, first statement is from the load going towards the generator, and second statement is from the generator going towards the load. Okay, तो एक first statement में आप right hand side से left hand side में जा रहे हो, और second statement में where we are saying that from the generator towards the load we are going. The cases respectively. So let us start the videos and pay attention very carefully. In yesterday session I showed you how Smith chart looks like. Okay, and today in these two videos we will have the much more detailing about it. I will share those videos with you. Please let me know if voice is audible.
In this session, I'll be going to explain Smith chart.
Okay, thank you.
And how to solve examples of Smith chart. So here we can see this is a Smith chart where first we need to understand what is the meaning of these circles which is there in this Smith chart. So in this Smith chart, there are basically two types of circles. One is you can observe these circles. So these circles are real circles. So that gives idea about real value of impedance which is there with this Smith chart. And second is these circles. So these are imaginary circles. So imaginary circles are having basically two categories. Positive imaginary and negative imaginary. Positive imaginary circles that lies above this horizontal line. So positive imaginary circles that is there above this horizontal line, and negative imaginary circles that is there below this horizontal line. So this is how these circles are there. Now what are the other things which we need to keep it in our mind? So in this Smith chart, at this position, we have value of V max and Z max. And at this side, we have a value of V min and Z min. So when we solve microwave circuits, we have standing pattern, so that is what resulting into V max and V min. So V max that is there on this side of this Smith chart, and V min that is there on this side of Smith chart. So V min and Z min that lies over here, and V max and Z max that lies in this direction. Now if the scales which gives idea about what is the value of VSWR. So this first horizontal line that is giving idea about value of VSWR, and this third line that is giving idea about value of reflection coefficient. So this is how this Smith chart is there. Now when we look impedance, then from load sometimes we move towards generator, and sometimes from generator we.
Do you believe somebody could be trained potentially to sense information not by reading a book?
Move towards low. So when we move towards the generator from load, we need to move in clockwise direction. So this is what towards the generator. So for that we need to move it in clockwise direction. And when we move towards the load, at that time we need to move in anti-clockwise direction. So towards the load, we need to move in anti-clockwise direction. So when we move from load, we need to move it towards the generator. And when we move from generator, we need to move towards the load. So for towards the generator, we need to move in clockwise direction. And for towards the load, we need to move it in anti-clockwise direction. Now to understand this, let us solve one basic problem so that we can have proper idea like what is that which we need to do. So here, let us consider one problem. Now see, in this problem, we have characteristic impedance, that is Z0. Load impedance, that is Z. So characteristic impedance is 50. Load impedance is 5 plus J25. And length of transmission line, that is 0.1 lambda. So by using this, there could be so many parameters which we can solve by using Smith chart. So let us solve those parameters, then we can understand what is the use of this Smith chart. So as it have been discussed in this problem, Z0, that is 50 ohm, and ZL, that is 5 plus J25 ohm. So in Smith chart, we need to plot impedance, but that should be normalized impedance. So normalized value of ZL, that is actual value of ZL divided by ZZ. So 5 plus J25 divided by 50. So that will be 0.1 plus J0.5. So when we plot ZL value on this Smith chart, real part of that should be 0.1 and imaginary part that should be positive 0.5. So here to plot that, we need to understand real part should be 0.1. So these are real circles. Now where this real circle is having 0.1 value with this circle. And imaginary, positive imaginary circles are this. So where 0.5 positive imaginary, that is this circle. So this real 0.1 and imaginary positive 0.5, that is intersecting at this position. So it intersect at this position. So we can say value of ZL at this point is 0.1 plus J0.5. So that is how we can plot a point ZL on this Smith chart. Now, by using this point, we can have a VSWR circle. So that will be a circle which is what we need to plot with respect to center. So right now, we will be plotting VSWR circle. Now you can see center, that is over here, and we are tracing circle with respect to this ZL. So this is what a circle which is VSWR circle. So you can say now this circle which is what we have traced, that is VSWR circle. Now, to understand how to calculate VSWR, we need to consider a VSWR circle intersecting to horizontal line. So horizontal line is this. So here it intersects at this point, this circle intersects at this point. So we need to stretch horizontal straight line from this . So now this line, which is what intersecting to horizontal line by VSWR circle, that is what we are stretching it to this scale where we can identify what is the value of VSWR. So here we can see this line intersecting over here to VSWR scale to this first line, that over here. So this idea about the value. And that is bisected by 5 points. So after 1 point, this scale is there. So we can say value of VSWR, that is 10 plus 1 point, and each point is having value of 2. So value of VSWR should be 12 approximately. And third scale, that is this, which is intersecting over here. So this scale explains you value of reflection coefficient. So that is there in between 0.8 and 0.9, and that is again bisecting by 5 points, and that is there after second. So it is there in between 0.8 and 0.9. So after 2 point it is there. So value of reflection coefficient is 0.84. So VSWR circle gives idea about what should be the value of VSWR and reflection coefficient for this transmission line. Now, to understand some other parameters, what we can do is we can calculate input impedance. Now, in this problem, it is given length of transmission line is 0.1 lambda. So let us first of all plot a line which is what exactly coming out from center to ZL. So this line, that is what coming out from center to ZL. So now we can see this line is intersecting to angle over here. So what does that point indicates? This point indicates a value of reflection coefficient at ZL. Now reflection coefficient, that is magnitude of reflection coefficient into e raised to j psi, where psi is what phase of reflection coefficient. So over here, angle is in between 130 and 120. Angle is in between 130 and 120. So it is there after 120, we can say this is almost 126. So value of reflection coefficient is 0.84 and angle is e to the power j 126 degree. Now, what does this point indicates? So this point indicates ZL is having a position that is there in between 0.07 and 0.08 lambda. So that is exactly in between 0.07 and 0.08. So we can say this point, that is 0.075 lambda. Now how this point is useful? This point is useful to calculate what should be input impedance, as it is given length of transmission line to be 0.1 lambda. So we need to go towards the generator to have a calculation of input impedance. So length is 0.1 lambda. 0.1 lambda towards the generator, where we can say input impedance is there. So 0.075 lambda plus 0.1. So that is 0.175 lambda. So we can see this is gradually increasing, and over here this is 0.17 and 0.18. so in between these two, a point which is what, 0.175 lambda. Now from this point, if we stretch a straight line to the center, this line intersects VSWR circle over here. So this point is input impedance. So we are moving in clockwise direction by 0.1 lambda to have input impedance. Now what is the value of Zin? So value of Zin, and 2, this is 0.2 real circle, and in between that this is 0.3 real circle, and this point is there in between 0.4 and 0.4 only. So that is there very nearer to 0.4, so we can say real part is 0.4, and imaginary circle, that is in between 1.8 and 2.0, so that is there on 1.9, and these are positive imaginary circle, so Zin value will be J 1.9. so that is how we can solve what is the value of Zin by plotting that on Smith chart by moving 0.1 lambda towards the generator from the value of load. Now what will be the value of reflection coefficient over here? So for that we need to see what is the angle. So at this point we can see angle is there in between 50 and 60. So that angle is almost 55. So if I say this angle, that is having 55 degrees, so reflection coefficient, so that is value 0.84, and angle, that is JSI, which is what, 55 degrees. So 55, so magnitude of reflection coefficient is 0.84, and it is there at angle 55 degrees. So this is how we can solve the basic values which is there with reflection coefficient with respect to angle, Zin, Zl, VSWR, reflection coefficient. Now what are the other things which we can understand? So one more thing that we can understand, which is what is the difference in between maxima to the input impedance. So maxima, that is aparted by this much amount of distance from input impedance, and minima, that is aparted by this much amount of distance with respect to input impedance. So we can say this distance is there from 0.18 to 0.25. So 0.25 minus 0.175. So that is what the gap which is there in between maxima to input impedance, and 0.1, that gap will be, let us solve that. So distance, this, so that is actually 0.25 minus 0.175, so that is 0.075. so this is 0.075 lambda. So that is a gap in between Zmin and Vmax and Zin. So this is actually this is actually half of the circle, which is what, 0.25 plus 0.075. So that is 0.325. So 0.325 lambda, that is the distance of Zin with respect to Vmin. So that is how we can calculate basic things of Smith chart. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. And if any query is there regarding.
Okay. This was the first video where we talked about, the author talked about the VSWR circle obtained from the given load impedance. Okay, load impedance jo bhi diya hua tha usko pehle normalize kar lo. Normalize kar lo matlab divide that load impedance by its characteristic impedance. To wo jo point aayega wo aap plot kar lijiye, draw a circle through that point with the center of the Smith chart. That circle will be called as VSWR. And if we extend a line, okay, this line, ये जहाँ पे भी इंटरसेक्ट कर रही है हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस को, वहाँ से अगर आप एक्सटेंड करते हो और नीचे जो स्केल दिया हुआ है आपके स्मिथ चार्ट के, एंड इफ यू एक्सटेंड टू दैट स्केल, देन वी विल हैव द टू क्वांटिटीज, द VSWR, ओके, VSWR ड्यू टू दैट काइंड ऑफ लोड इम्पिडेंस. जो भी लोड है, जो भी लोड इम्पिडेंस है, उसकी वजह से जो भी VSWR जनरेट होगा, स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशो जनरेट होगा, उसका मैग्नीट्यूड क्या आएगा, तो 12 आएगा फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट स्केल. इफ यू एक्सटेंड दैट लाइन फर्दर ऑन द थर्ड स्केल, वी विल हैव द रिफ्लेक्शन कोएफिशिएंट वैल्यू. ओके, तो ये दो वैल्यू से इफ वी द लाइन को आप एक्सटेंड कर सकते ड्रॉ करने के बाद. Then we have seen that if we extend the line further, okay, then on this scale we do have the angles. Ye jo 110, 120, 130, 140 dikh raha hai, this will give us the angles associated with the reflection coefficient. Okay, angles hai matlab we are talking about the phase shift in between the incident wave and the reflected wave. तो उनका angle कितना रहेगा. And if we further go ahead with the same line and we plot another point onto the Smith chart, okay, now do remember that this brown line is a line passing through the load impedance. So this line indicates the distance of the load, okay, distance of the load, or this line indicates a load line which is present at 0.075 lambda. Okay, ye jo scale diya hua hai, one is in a clockwise direction and another is in anti-clockwise direction. So if we are going towards the generator, we have to follow the clockwise direction scale, and if we are moving towards the load, we have to follow the anti-clockwise scale. To ye jo point hai, it is a load point. Okay, load point mil gaya. And later we know that ki bhi jo transmission line thi, uska length diya hua tha something 0.1 lambda. Okay, so from this 0.075 lambda, we are moving towards the generator by a distance of 0.1 lambda. So 0.075 lambda plus 0.1 lambda, so it will result into 0.175 lambda. Mark that point and then draw a line through that point to the center of the Smith chart. Now wherever that line intersects the VSWR constant voltage standing wave ratio, us point ko aap mark kar lijiye, and that will give you the input impedance. And now you know how to read the points because you know how to plot the points, okay, on the Smith chart. तो ये आपका इनपुट इम्पिडेंस फॉर द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. ओके, एंड then if we talk about the reflection coefficient towards the generator, तो आप उस reflection coefficient जो आपने पहले भी calculate किया था on the scale, it was 0.84. Let me go back into the video. ये देखिए reflection coefficient was 0.84 from the scale. So its magnitude doesn't change, but yes, now its angle gets changes. Okay, its angle gets changed. So J55. From where we read the value? From here. This 50, 60. Okay. So in between we do have that point, and that point is going to give us the angle associated with the reflection coefficient at the generator side. We do have this angle which explains us the amount of phase shift in the transmitter or this is the input impedance, or this is the input impedance line. Okay, this another line on the left hand side is a load impedance line. Okay, input impedance and load impedance. So whenever we talk about the input impedance line, we can find the distance at which we will get the maximum value of the voltage. Okay, so we know that on this side of Smith chart we have the values of Vmax and Zmax. Okay, so this is a point where we are going to get a maximum value of the voltage. So what is the distance in between at this distance where we are getting the maximum value of the voltage and the input side, or we will say the generator side? So what is the distance between the input impedance line and this horizontal line? Okay, so yahan pe agar aap dekhoge, so this point मेरा एरो दिख रहा है, माउस दिख रहा है, प्लीज यस और नो, कैन यू सी द माउस? ओके ग्रेट,
यस सर,
ग्रेट, थैंक यू. सो एट दिस पॉइंट वी से दैट ओके दिस इज योर व्हाट आई विल से दैट 0.25 लैम्डा डिस्टेंस, एंड ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड यू विल हैव 0.5 लैम्डा डिस्टेंस. ओके, सो दीज आर द स्टैंडर्ड डिस्टेंसेस. I will repeat, this is a point at 0.25 lambda, and on the left hand side on the same horizontal axis we will have the 0.5 lambda. This is 0.25 lambda and left hand side is 0.5 lambda. So what is the distance indicated by this blue line is 0.25 lambda minus this 0.175 lambda, and it comes out to be 0.075 lambda. Okay, so this is the distance in between. I repeat the sentence, this is the distance in between the generator side and the maximum Vmax value, maximum value of voltage. Generator se kyon se distance pe, kitne distance pe aapko maximum voltage mil sakta hai. Okay, and that distance comes out 0.75. The video. So here, okay, so here on this side we will have the 0.5 lambda, and this is a point of V minimum or Z minimum. So we will find the distance of this point from the input impedance line or generator side line. So in dono ke beech mein difference kya aayega? So 0.5 minus ye kya tha aapka 0.175, that much distance will be in between the generator to the minimum voltage value. Okay, so iski wajah se we always have the transformers for different areas, so that we will have maximum voltage transferred or transmitted for the energy or electricity. Okay, moving on to the next video. That is also a nice video by an English person. Let me share that video with you. And that is of 15 minutes, but yes, what I will do, I will truncate that video to what I will say the important part, the discussion where we want to have the exact understanding. Shared. Okay. Okay.
In my previous video, we took a look at the Smith chart and how the impedance and transmission line effects type format by converting 6 minus J 1.02, this normalized load impedance.
Okay, so this normalized load impedance we are going to plot on the Smith chart.
I'll just call ZL. Being capacitive, we're going to be in the lower half of the Smith chart here.
And since the normalized load impedance was having negative sign, therefore negative sign for the imaginary part, therefore we have plotted that point below the horizontal axis. Okay, below the horizontal axis.
So we start off by looking at the 0.66 real component, and that is basically right next to this line right in here. And then we're also going to look at the intersection of 1.0 on the side.
Is your capacitive load
here. To verify our point in the Smith chart, I took a 33 ohm and 220 picofarad capacitor, soldered them in series across. Actually, very simply, just read them off. We simply take a set of dividers, plotted right here. Okay.
So we have drawn a line through that load impedance. So this becomes the load line on the Smith chart. Okay. And if we draw the circle and we stretch the line onto the scales. Okay. Yahan pe jo niche scale hai, wahan pe aap stretch kar lijiye. Jo bhi circle aap draw karne wale ho through the load impedance point, that circle is called as VSWR circle. Okay. And if you draw that circle and you extend the point of interaction of intersection of that circle and the horizontal axis onto the scales given below the Smith chart, we will have the SWR value, that is VSWR value, as well as the reflection coefficient value. Okay, reflection coefficient value. So VSWR value and the reflection coefficient value, that 0.54, from where we get this value, -76.4 angle, these angles. Okay, the angles given over here, angles given for the reflection coefficient or transmission coefficient. For our case, we are not going to use the transmission coefficient angles, but yes, reflection coefficient angles are given and can be obtained by extending the load line into the exterior of the Smith chart. Or yahan pe jo point of intersection hai, to wahan pe aapko आपका एंगल रीड करने के लिए मिल जाएगा. डू रिमेंबर दैट सिंस वी आर ऑन द बॉटम हाफ ऑफ द स्मिथ चार्ट, आवर एंगल इज नेगेटिव. यू कैन ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व सम ऑफ द एंगल्स, -60, -70, -80, -90, -100 आर गिवन इन द नेगेटिव. ओके, सो व्हेन एवर वी आर लुकिंग एट द रिफ्लेक्शन कोएफिशिएंट एंगल्स इन डिग्रीज, फॉलो दिस स्केल दैट गोज इन अ क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. ओके, the upper scale, the angles for the transmission coefficients are also going in a clockwise direction, but that is a bottom scale. So reflection coefficient are upper scale and the transmission coefficient angles are in the bottom scale. So this is important. I intended to have you to have the what I will say that a practical implementation of the Smith chart. This Smith chart is on the kind of CRO. Okay, if we do have a load impedance described by our characteristics, you can find this is the point plotted by the CRO, not exactly the CRO, but yes, it looks like a CRO. That's why I am referring it as a CRO. तो आपको प्रैक्टिकल भी दिखाना चाहता था विच इज नॉट इन द सिलेबस बट दैट गिव्स यू द कंफर्टनेस कि भाई क्या चीज़ें हो रही हैं एंड वेदर इट रियली यूज इन द प्रैक्टिकल केसेस और नॉट ओके सो दैट वॉट आई इंटेंडेड बट ओके फाइन वी आर आउट ऑफ टाइम राइट नाउ सो आई विल स्टॉप शेयरिंग एनी वेज दैट वॉज आउट ऑफ द सिलेबस But understanding the VSWR to solve the sorry, understanding the Smith chart to solve the numerical was the intention for today's session. I will share with you the two numerical, and those two numerical are sufficient, self-sufficient to solve any numerical. Okay, I will repeat, those two numerical are self-sufficient to solve any numerical asked in the examination. Okay, along with that, it is important to understand the Smith chart from the MCQ point of view. तो वो भी बुलेट्स में दे दूंगा दो जो स्टेटमेंट्स आई विल गिव यू तो वो स्टेटमेंट्स याद रखना जरूरी है एनी वेज यू आर गोइंग टू यूज दो स्टेटमेंट्स वाइल सॉल्विंग द न्यूमेरिकल बट द थिंग्स एंड द माइंड गेम्स बिकम डिफरेंट व्हेन द सेम थिंग्स आर आस्क्ड इनसाइड द एग्जाम एज एमसीक्यू ओके दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे सेशन